गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 11. इन आवर प्रीवियस टू क्लासेस वी हैव स्टार्टेड द चैप्टर, द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ योर बायोलॉजी बुक, दैट इज द लिविंग वर्ल्ड. टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू द चैप्टर. सो इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी हैव कंप्लीटेड दैट डिफरेंट व्हाट इज टैक्सोनॉमी एंड डिफरेंट characteristics of living and binomial nomenclature, different criteria of that nomenclature. Okay, so today we'll start with the taxonomic category. So a new term, that is taxonomic category. In our last class, you came to know that what is taxonomy. Now, this term is new. What is category? What does that term mean, taxonomy category? So, as we know that classification is not a single step process. It involves a hierarchy of steps. Classification is not a single step process. It involves hierarchy of steps. And each step is called as category. It is a unit. Okay, so category is the one part of overall taxonomic arrangement. It is the one part of overall taxonomic arrangement. So I am giving you one example. So before that example, I have used another term, that is hierarchy. So another term is taxonomy hierarchy. What is that? What is taxonomy hierarchy? Taxonomy hierarchy, that means all categories are together are called as taxonomic hierarchy. That means all categories together constitute the taxonomic hierarchy. As I have told that there are so many steps in taxonomy, hierarchical steps, and each step is category. So all the categories together are called as hierarchy. So now we will consider examples. So what is that? These are taxonomic hierarchy. Then we can write okay. So I am repeating what are they. They are first of all kingdom. It is the highest one. And after that phylum, class, order, family, genus, species. These are examples of category. So kingdom is a category, phylum is a category, class is a category, and under that kingdom we will find that plant kingdom and animal kingdom. Plant kingdom and animal kingdom. So under this we will find different phylum, that is Porifera, Cnidaria, Platyhelminthes. Okay, these are called as taxa. Okay, or singular, it is called as taxon. So each category referred to as unit of classification, and it represents a rank, and this is called as, commonly called as taxon or taxa. Okay, so kingdom, phylum, class, order, these are under the category, and these are the under the kingdom or under the phylum, what come, these are under the taxon, or singularly it is called as taxa, and plural, if plural form is taxa. That means I am repeating that class, order, family, genus, species, these are the under category, and these are the under taxa or taxon. So if if I consider the next part, that means as we know that if we consider the examples of some insects, okay, as insects are having some common features, like they are having three pairs of jointed legs, okay, so that means they are classified or categorized into a given rank or category. Like that, all the organisms are categorized or classified, and they are provided with a particular taxa and particular category. Okay, so next part is we have to know all the meaning of all these terms. What is kingdom? What is phylum? What is class? What is order? Okay, one by one, once we come to know the meaning of that terms. So first we will start with the species. Okay, so first we will start with the species. So species is the lowest category, as we have seen, and I have written it at the last. A question may arise in our mind that how an organism will be placed, or how different organisms will be placed in different categories. So for that we are going to that next part. First of all, we will consider the species. That means how will you categorize, or how will you give an place an organism in a particular category? That is according to their characters. According to the characters of individual organism or group, some characters will be similar and some characters will be dissimilar. So according to the similarities and dissimilarities in character, we will classify them, or different categories will be found there. So first is category. Okay, that means what that term means, species. So species consider a group of individuals with fundamental similarities, a group of individuals which are having some common characters or similarities are called as species. So if I consider an example, that is how to write the binomial names. That is, first one is genus, second one is species, and so we are talking about now about species. So here Leo is the species, Tigris is the species. So some characteristics which are present only that group of animals, that's why they are under this Leo group. That means lions are considered in this group. So lions and tigers, they are having some common features, like they are under the same genus. So with that, after that we will come to know what is genus. So genus comprises a group of related species which has more characteristics in common in comparison to species. Okay, so some group of related species are put together under a same genus. Okay, so Panthera leo, Panthera tigris. Leo, Panthera leo is under is lion, and Panthera tigris is tiger. They are species are different, but they are under, they are having the same genus. Okay, so that means these are based on the some distinct morphological difference. So species can be considered based on the some distinct morphological difference, or we can distinguish one species from other with the based on the some distinct morphological characteristics. Okay, so with that example we can easily understand that species part. So if we consider that there are another examples like solanum tuberosum, so solanum and solanum nigrum. So these are solanum is includes the same genus, but tuberosum and nigrum indicate two different species. There are so many examples we can find, that means by which we can define species, and with the species we came to know what is genus also. That means genus comprises a group of related species which has more characteristics in common in comparison to species, okay, of other genera. Species of other genera, you need to mention that part, that is species of related to other genera. So as I have mentioned that potato and brinjal and both tiger and lion, you can see they are having common genus, that is Panthera, but there's for lion they are having, and for lion and tiger they are having two different species. So if we consider that solanum part also, that potato and brinjal, they are under the genus solanum. Solanum tuberosum, Solanum nigrum. So they are under different species, but their genus is similar, Solanum. Okay. So with a single example, we came to know what is species and what is genus. Next we come, we will know the what is family. Next part is what is family. So family is a group of related genera with still less number of similarities as compared to genus and species. Okay, so I am repeating, a group of genus will form a family, a group of genus and both a group of species will form a genus, a group of genus will form a family, and in that case with related genera will be with less number of similarities as compared to the genus and species will be, because a species, if we consider a species, there will be specified some characters which will specify that that one is particular species. Okay, so whenever we will go higher to species to genus, the number of characteristics goes on decreasing. So I am repeating that a group of genus will form a family. Okay, as that a group of species will form a genus and a group of genus will form a family. Okay, so the family, I am repeating that it is the next category, and which is a group of related genera with less number of similarities as compared to genus and species. So here we will come to know a family. Solanaceae. Okay, it is an example of plant family Solanaceae, and Solanum, Petunia, Datura, Solanum, Petunia, Datura, all will be under this family Solanaceae. Okay, they are having different genus, they are having different species, but they will be under the same family, which is Solanaceae. As another example in case of animal, that is the if I consider tiger, lion, leopard, that is lion, leopard, tiger. Okay, these are, as we know, the lion and tiger are under one genus, but they are under different species, but along there is a genus that is Panthera, and there is another genus which are under the cat family, not family, which are under the cat, which are considered as common name is cats, which is Felis. Okay, that means cats all are under the family Felidae. Okay, so they are having different genus. Tiger, cats, they are having different genus, but they are grouped under a common family which is called as felidae. Okay, so this is an example that if we imagine a cat and a dog, we think that they are having some common features, but they are under different families, that is felidae and canidae. Felidae and canidae. Okay, they are under different family. So with that we have came to know that what are families. Next we will proceed to the order. Next part is, or next category is order. So here some families will be under a order. So some families with the based on number of similar characters, some families based on the similar characters will be under a category which is called as order. Okay, and it is a, if we consider an example, that is we have seen that Solanaceae, and another example is Convolvulaceae. These are included in the same family. And if we consider that as in the last part, Felidae, Canidae, they were under different family. These are under different family, cats and dogs. Okay, but they are under same order, Carnivora. Okay, so some families according to their similar characteristics will be under a category which is called as order. Okay, next we will proceed for the class. Next class, so this category is includes related orders. Related order, same. Okay, so last part was order, so some related orders will be grouped under a category which is called as class. So as if we consider an example that some animals, carnivores, we have considered that Carnivora in that order. So Carnivora includes what are the examples, like tiger, cat, dog. Okay, so they will be under class Mammalia. Okay, they will be under class Mammalia. And if we consider another order which is called as Primata, gorilla, gibbon, chimpanzee, they will be under the class Primata. And that cat family, cat, dog, that means carnivores and primates, carnivores, Carnivora, these are the examples of two order. They will be under class Mammalia. They will be under class Mammalia. So our group of related orders will be under a same class. Next we will proceed to the phylum. So next part is phylum. So our phylum includes some related classes. That means belonging to different class but having few characteristics in common, which will be under phylum. Okay, so related classes, that means some classes which are having some characteristics in common, they will be under same phylum. Okay, as we have considered that there are so many phyla that if we consider that phylum Chordata. So they are having some common examples, like presence of notochord, nonchord, dorsal hollow, nonchord, and pharyngeal gill slits. Okay, so these are the some common characteristics by which we, groups of organisms will be same phylum. So as we have considered that phylum, an example of phylum is Chordata, and they are having some common characteristic, that is dorsal hollow neural system, notochord, presence of notochord, pharyngeal gill slits, etc. Okay, so next part is that higher part, that is kingdom. is the highest category and all animals belonging to different phyla assigned into a category which is called a kingdom. Okay, all the phyla are assigned into a single category according to their character, similar characters under a kingdom animal, kingdom. And we will find two kingdom, that is Animalia and Plantae. Okay, so under Animalia we can find different phyla like Porifera, Cnidaria, Echinoderma, Platyhelminthes, Annelida, as Chordata, Hemichordata, okay, all are under phylum Animalia. And in case of Plantae, we will find that algae, Gymnosperm, Angiosperm, there are so many examples which are under that kingdom. Okay, and in our classification system, we will find that five kingdom classification system. So, in our next chapter we will read that part, that is five kingdom classification system. So in our whatever which organisms are present, or animals or plants or any other organisms around us, they are grouped into five kingdom. Okay, Monera, Protista, Plantae, Fungi, Animalia. Okay, so after that we have completed all the categories, but you have to keep remember one point, that higher from species to kingdom, the number of common characters will be. Whenever we will go higher from species to kingdom, the number of common characteristics will be decreasing. As I have told repeatedly, that in case of species, they are having particular characters, so that particular same character, so that they are under the same species. Okay, so whenever we will go higher from species to kingdom, the number of common characters, that means dissimilarity in characters, will be seen there. So in your book there is a table, that is there are some examples showing that organisms with their taxonomic categories, that is man, housefly, mango and wheat, four examples are over there. So just try to remember that part. Okay, so in our next class we will start with the taxonomical examples.